Welcome to the You Are Home Life Tour of Gregson Hall. It's Friday, July 13th. It's 10 a.m. So this is Gregson Hall. I'm Matea Jones. I'm a senior here at the University of Arkansas. I'm studying food science. And with us today is Courtney. Courtney, do you want to say hi?
Yeah. Hey, guys. So I'm going to be videoing today. My name's Courtney. I'm about to begin my sophomore year here at the University of Arkansas. I'm a nursing major, and I'm from Fayetteville, so let me know if you guys have any questions. We'll be answering all of them for you guys today, and feel free to comment while we're videoing and afterwards, and I'll be sure to go through and answer all of those for you guys. Thank you.
Yeah, so I guess we'll start out here today. So this is Gregson Hall. We're in the heart of campus right now. So around us we have Gibson Hall across the street, along with Ruff Dining Hall that has Starbucks in it, Ruff A-Go-Go, Quiznos, and then next door you'll find a great meal trade options at Founders Hall that includes Slim's, Where the Wild Greens Are, Rock Taco, a lot of great options to eat around here. And then right down the street is going to be the Union. So all your activities will be central on campus, real easy to get to, great place to be on campus. And then you have the great view of Fayetteville down there, stadium's close by. It's really like the heart of campus, the heart of Fayetteville, and a great place to be.
Yeah.
So I guess we'll go ahead and go inside now, and we'll show you guys around Gregson Hall. Mm-hmm.
Say where you're from?
Oh, I'm from Frisco, Texas, so about 5 hours away from here in a suburb outside of Dallas.
Frisco, but, huh?
Yeah.
That was our fog system.
Yes.
Security.
So each building comes equipped with a fog system for security wise, so you have to live in the building to have a fog for that building. So if you have guests coming over, you'll have to come downstairs to get them and escort them up yourself. But it's a great security measure that we have on campus. Helps everyone feel safe at night.
Yeah.
So this is the lobby area of Gregson. It's got lots of great spaces. It's real like hotel-like, if you know what I mean. Great marbling, all that kind of stuff. It looks really good in pictures. Mm-hmm. We'll take pictures down here. And I guess we'll go this way. We'll see the front desk area where you can get your mail, check things out. So this is the front desk of Gregson Hall. This is going to be your hall secretary. What's your name again?
Kusum.
Kusum. So you'll come here to get your mail. If you want to check out DVDs, games, things like that, you'll come here and check them out with either her or an RA at night. And yeah, if you have any questions during the day, this is also where you're come. You're locked out, you need to find something, you're lost on campus, things like that.
And you were an RA at one point too, is that
yes,
right?
Yes, I was an RA for the past 2 years in Maple Hill South. It was a great experience, loved it, highly recommend it, especially if you really like interacting with students. So get involved with like your hall leadership, the lead hogs, things like that. It's a great way to get involved and to learn more about the campus. If you'll turn around over here, this is where your mailbox will be if you live here in Gregson Hall. So you'll get an email later on in the summer with your number and then your mailbox code. So you'll share this mailbox with your roommate. So it'll be the same one for you and your direct roommate.
So if they get packages, they pick them up at the front desk,
yes,
right?
Yes, if they're too small to go into your mailbox, you'll just come here during the front desk hours. I think it's, for this hall, it's 1 to 4 p.m. And you'll come here, she'll give her your ID, your name, and she will check it out for you. And then you'll have all your stuff.
Awesome.
Yes.
I think we're going to check out the basement area.
Yeah, we'll go downstairs and see all the cool things down there. So yeah. Much in this building.
So what year are you again?
I'm a senior.
You're a senior.
So
okay.
My last year.
So 4 years here at least. What have you learned over your years at the university that you would tell a freshman coming? Like, what's number one thing?
Parking is no joke. Do not mess with parking and transit. They are serious. And not to be messed with.
Okay. So respect the P&T.
Respect parking. Don't think you can outsmart them because they will find you. There's some construction and maintenance going on in this building right now. So we'll head down over here. Right here is a trash room. So there are trash chutes on the buildings that lead down here so that you don't have to take your trash everywhere. But it's a great tool. And they're cleaned every Thursday and noon to two. Yeah, so if you want to just look inside. So the chute is from the upper floors and just comes right down here. So you don't have to worry about your trash. Bring it all the way downstairs.
And do we, there's three floors, is that right here?
Yes.
Okay. And so approximately 200 and something students?
I think of 200, yeah, it has to be 202 students to make it even. But it's a usually an upperclassman dorm, co-ed, so just a great environment. Great study spaces, too, because it's upperclassmen, so people are really dedicated to their studies here, so you'll find lots of great groups to study with and to hang out with if you're looking for other like-minded people who are about their academics. That's what we're all here for, so we'll go this way. So this is the basement of Gregson Hall. Lots of great common spaces to hang out in. And just really long. So another staircase that leads upstairs. And this is the main like hangout area for this room. So this is the lounge, there's a library, lots of great seating, great study spaces or a group meeting space if you have organizations that have to have meetings at night. Lots of great books and games up on the shelves. And then we come into the TV lounge area. Great seating. Movie nights, there's a DVD player. You can check out movies upstairs or bring your own. You could probably even like HDMI yourself into it if you want to watch a certain show or if you like are having a presentation or have a group meeting. Great way to use the space down here.
Any movie recommendations you'd make to folks?
Ooh.
Anything you've seen lately that you especially liked?
I saw Ocean's 8 the other
Me
a couple
too.
Weeks ago with my friends. It was so funny. I can't wait to get it when it comes out on DVD.
I saw that this week. Like it was really good. Show.
And so over here is a kitchen. So you have an ice machine, a fridge, and a refrigerator.
Light here.
Yeah. So. A nice ice machine. A fridge, a common fridge and refrigerator that anyone can use, a little eating space, a sink, kitchen, a real oven, real full-size oven, so if you want to cook for yourself or you need a treat, you can always come down here, make it yourself, if you're tired of the dining hall food, because it might happen. Sometimes you just don't want to eat at the dining halls, but they're all good, so.
What's a dish that you prepared, either as an RA or when you were a student here?
There was one night, we had like a taco night. So me and a couple friends went to the store, got all the things necessary for tacos, and to the full like taco fiesta night in the kitchen. And it was a great experience. We had lots of fun memories. We played like salsa music and had like chips and salsa. Like, we're gonna make it the full experience.
Donna says, thanks for doing this. These Facebook Live tours are so helpful.
You're welcome. We're glad we got to do this for you guys.
Yeah. Feel free to tell us where you guys are from.
Yes, especially my Texas people because, you know, Texas is the best in all 50 states, but we do love Arkansas. I'm a little biased. But yeah, so lots of space to store stuff. It's a great space to like, hang out with your friends and just be together.
Yeah.
So we'll come out here, back out to the common space, and next door to the kitchen.
Let's mention the recycling too, that area over there.
So this building also has really great recycling, and so you can like separate all the stuff. We do a Recycle Mania every year. The halls compete against each other to see like which one recycles more than the other. I think Gregson always does really well for the halls, and so. I think there's spaces either not on every floor, but at least there's always going to be recycling down here in the basement. And then next door to the kitchen is going to be your laundry room. It's a nice big laundry room. So you're going to have 5 washers and 6 dryers. So, and each of these comes with a scan that you can scan to see like when they're open, when they're free. There's an app you can download. I think it's called Laundry Alert. And so you can just come down here, see which one you have your stuff in, and then you can go to the app, like set an alert for it so that when it's done, you can go all the way up to your room and come right back down when it's done. You don't have to stay down here.
And when it comes to that, you can go to housing.uark.edu/laundry and find out more about that service.
If there's ever a problem, there's also a number on the washer to report that, or you can tell an RA or the front desk and we can get it figured out for you guys.
Yeah.
So you don't have to pay for it, it's completely free, which is a great thing. You don't have to pay to use the washer, all you can do is buy your own soap.
It's within your student fees.
Yes,
so when you pay for housing, it's covered within it. It's not technically free, but you don't have to have quarters or anything like that.
You don't have to pay every single time you do it. You pay the front for it. Yeah, and then there's a sink over here if you need to get a stain out for something. A folding table so you can fold your laundry down here. Because, you know, if it goes upstairs not folded, it might not ever get folded again.
Very true.
And then we'll come back outside. So also down here, when you come in the basement, there's some vending machines for snacks. You can use cash or card or even Apple Pay and Android Pay, so you can just tap and get a snack or a drink. There's a pool table down here. You can check out the balls that go to this pool table upstairs at the front desk, a bathroom, and then more common spaces. Just this place is full of places to meet with your friends and to study and meet together.
What's your game? Is it pool or ping pong or foosball?
I am more of a pool person.
Okay.
They tried to teach me how to play ping pong freshman year. I still not have been able to do it. I'm just not fast enough for it. I can't get to the ball, but they keep trying. Maybe one day. So over here, we see some of the study spaces that are available in this building. So we have a whole room that has a whiteboard and some chairs in it. So if you need to strategize how to study for something, or just like trying to teach someone something, you have a place to do that. You got the ping pong table I still don't know how to use. It's okay. And then behind you, we have another study space. These classrooms like this are usually set up for SI instructional time, which is your supplemental instruction that go along with some of your classes. So in those big classes where there's 400 plus students, you don't necessarily have the time to talk to your teacher about all your questions. So you'll have an SI that goes along with that class where you can talk to a student who really knows that subject and can help you learn that week's materials. So this might be one of the places that you do it. So if you live here, it'll be real convenient to come downstairs and go to SI.
And there's Class Plus is located in Gregson, so do you mind just telling us a little bit about what Class Plus is?
So Class Plus is basically your go-to to help you get through school. It has tutoring, there's a writing center, there is just like help. If you need help in anything, Class Plus is where you're gonna go to figure out that class. So there's an enhanced learning center located in Gregson. You kind of have to go outside and go around to get to it, but it's real convenient if you need to run and learn something or turn in the paper real fast to get reviewed before you have to turn it in that day. So it's a really great source. I really highly recommend that you use it. I know I've sent in so many papers to get reviewed because that's one of my struggles is writing papers and reports. And so turn that in, someone will talk through it with you. It's a great tool to use. You have to use it. Please use it. You're already paying for it and your student fees. Might as well use it. Yeah, so we'll come back out this way. Isn't this place is so great?
Yeah, that's a really good spot
nice
to hang out.
RAs will have programs down here. It's a great thing to hang out and just get to know each other, especially those first couple of weeks where you don't really know anyone.
So we can, that was the study room we just looked at,
door.
So we'll probably go ahead and, there's a nice whiteboard in there. Maybe we'll just go upstairs.
Yep.
And
we'll just head upstairs now and see maybe a room and a bathroom.
And there's no elevator, so be aware of that. But only 3 floors, so maybe that's just within the healthy.
Yes. You'll get your steps in after.
Mm-hmm.
That leads outside. There's another door into the building. And we'll walk down this way. Some more spaces to study. Everyone's rooms.
Yeah. Those little corner areas are nice. Sometimes people just use those areas as well.
So this is the bathroom. So this hall comes with a common bathroom. So you'll share with the people on the floor. Let's just. Hello?
We don't want to intrude.
Hello. So this is going to be the bathroom. Over here, we're going to have the sinks. And there's a lot of them, so it's lots of great space. You'll probably never run out of a sink to use. So you have 6 sinks, a long bar with plugs. You can use it to your hair, do your makeup, and they're cleaned every day for you, so you don't have to worry about that. You don't stock it, you just use it. Treat it respectfully because everyone has to use it, but it's a great thing.
Are there any tips and tricks when it comes to using the bathroom when it's more of a community style?
Kind of have to go at odd times sometimes, especially if it's a busy weekend. Don't try to go at the regular times. You gotta switch it up, go a little early, go a little late.
Yeah.
So this used to be a male dorm only.
Oh yeah, a lot of them. So flowers.
So because this is a girl's restroom, put flowers in it to kind of make it seem more cute.
Spruce
up. Yes. And so these are going to be the toilets. There's 4 of them. And then over here is going to be the shower area. So this is great because it comes with nice hooks to like set your stuff up if you have a lot of things or changing clothes. And then if you come all the way in, there's going to be 3 shower stalls. And so each stall has a little changing area inside of it. So you can close it, change, like get ready, and then inside there's going to be the actual shower. And it's actually a really good size shower. Really wide, really nice. There's even a little seat. Sometimes you just kind of want to sit in the shower. So you're never going to run out of hot water, which is always a good thing, especially for girls, because I know I like a nice, long, hot shower, so never had to worry that someone else is going to take all the hot water. But yeah, so 3 of these. There's going to be 2 of these bathrooms on each floor. And so you shouldn't have a problem finding a shower, finding a bathroom. If one's full, you can probably always go down the hall to the next one, and it'll be just as convenient. Yeah, so these are really nice bathrooms, and again, you don't have to clean them, which is always a plus for me.
Yeah, definitely.
So can you pull that out and go see your room now? Yeah. Does anyone have any questions?
Feel free to let us know.
Yeah. We'll be happy to answer any questions.
Yep.
Is it unlocked?
Yes. It is unlocked.
So if you're going to live in Gregson Hall 142, this will be your room. Come in. There's going to be 2 beds, 2 desks, 2 chairs, and then 2 closets, and 2 sets of drawers. This is actually a really great sized room, lots of space. You won't feel like you're crowding your roommate. You got your light switches, and then a great closet with lots of nice space.
It's so tight on that closet.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
On that closet.
So girls, you have all the space for all your clothes. You'll never run out. Well, you shouldn't run out. Doesn't mean you won't. Because I know I always feel like I end up the year with more stuff than I came with.
So I'm wondering, a lot of times we recommend in housing that students bring the seasonably appropriate.
Yes. Always bring
clothing.
That current.
Did you follow that?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah?
I still do that. And so I usually come with summer and then the start of my fall. And so then when you go home for like fall break or Thanksgiving, you can take your summer stuff home and bring back the rest of your fall outfits. And then I do the same thing in the spring. So when it comes time for spring, break, I will, well, I come back from Christmas, I bring the winter, part of my winter stuff, or the end of my winter stuff, yeah. And then during spring break, I take that stuff home, and then try to decrease the amount of stuff you have in your room during spring break. That's your opportunity to take all the things home that you do not use, so that you don't have to move it all out at the end of the year, but then bring back summer or spring outfits. And that's a great way to use like your space. You won't feel overcrowded, and you won't have a bunch of clothes that you're not gonna wear.
There's also a cool little spot above the closet for extra storage. You need to use that.
So if you need to store like boxes or shoes, that can go there. A nice towel hook so that you can dry your towel.
Dawn says hello.
Hi, nice to see you guys. Oh, I guess I can't see you, but nice to hear from you.
We had a question from Donna. Yes. She said, what about microwaves and mini fridges? Do you rent from the school or bring your own?
So you can rent from the school, but you can also bring your own. There are certain requirements for that, which you can find on housing.urf.edu for like the wattage and things like that.
Move-in is probably a better site than that.
Move-in.urf.edu. And then microwaves, that you can bring this stuff, but like we showed you guys downstairs, there's a fridge and a microwave downstairs in the kitchen. So it's not necessarily like, you don't really need it, but you can bring it. It's just gonna take up space in your room.
Right.
We have a corporate partner that we work with. And one of the nice things about using that service is that it's here when you arrive.
Yeah.
And then you don't have to take it back home.
Yeah, you don't have to take it back home. You just turn it in at the end of the year and then it's over.
If you do choose to bring those, you could always loft your bed, which we have those options for you guys, and then you can, you know, take advantage of the storage under your bed if you'd like to put something under there.
This bed can go up twice as high, and you can loft it all the way up. You can go to movein.urf.edu to be like forwarded to the site where you can have it lofted for you. I had my bed lofted freshman year, and I really liked having extra space underneath. And I think halfway through, I de-lofted it because I got lazy. I hated climbing up bed and into bed. But it was nice to have that space.
Did you put anything underneath, like a food shop?
Yeah, I had my desk underneath, and my fridge, my microwave, because I bought one. But I also had extras at home, so we didn't have to buy it.
Sure.
But we lofted that. It's nice. We have a lot of floor space to have people in our room, especially at the beginning of the year. We're trying to make friends and get to know people, so we can hang out in the room. Yeah. These desks come with like shelving and drawers, so you don't have to necessarily bring things to put all your school supplies in.
Do you know the chair trick?
Yes. It took me so long to learn that, but you can. De-latch it and turn it into a little rocking stool, so it rocks, and then you have another little stool to sit on. So if you have more people in your room, you can turn two chairs into four. So that's really nice.
Mm-hmm. We'll point out the cable too. People sometimes ask about that.
Yes. So these rooms come with cable. We're real fancy like that. You get HBO and everything, all the HBOs. So it comes in your room. There'll be an HDMI cord and all the cording necessary for it, so you don't have to bring that with you. You can just plug in your TV and have all the cable necessary. I think you can even get DVR, but you have to pay extra for that.
It's an option.
It's an option.
You can go to housing.urf.edu/cable and find out more information about our cable
service. It's a great source. I miss it. I no longer live on campus. I'm a senior, so I moved off campus for jobs, but I miss having cable paid for, that's for sure. So use it while you have it. I remember we would always like be up in our rooms like at night watching The Bachelor, Scandal, all those things. It was a great way to like have fun with your friends at
those watch parties.
Yes, watch parties were a big thing. You would just find someone's room and just all pile in and watch it, or go downstairs to those meeting areas. It's a great way to spend the night.
Why don't we go ahead and measure the mattress? That's something we like to do, but we're also here to measure anything you want in this room.
Yes.
Now is the time to ask us, and we're happy to do it for you.
So the mattress is going to be 36.
Mm-hmm. You can hold it while she measures that one.
Oh, sure. I'll hold this for you.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, 36 by 80. I'm gonna measure the second one just to get our test on both. This is, I believe, not one of the halls where it's different on the window side versus the door side.
Yes, so this is also gonna end up being about 80 inches.
Okay, great.
And then it should be 36.
Yeah, I think all of them are about 36. Yeah.
And then did we get the depth? We've been asked about that before.
Right.
It's gonna be like 7 inches deep, 7-8 inches.
Okay.
And there's like a firm side and a like soft side, if you didn't know that. So you'll have to see like which side you like sleeping on. Oh. That took me a whole year to figure out. And I was real upset when I figured it out. But I spent a whole year sleeping on the firm side and I went the soft side.
Yes.
The desk. It's going to be 42 inches long and 24 and a half deep. So it's a nice little space to like do all your schoolwork, get spread out, get all your work done because you got to do the work to stay here.
And these are all movable pieces aside from the closet.
So you can always move around and rearrange the room however you like, move the beds, move the desks. As we said, you can loft your bed so you can put your desk underneath there. You can bring a futon if you like, it's not necessary. You can. This is honestly like a really good size room.
Yeah, very spacious.
You'll be really lucky if you live in here. So.
Why don't we give them the distance between the beds too? Because that's a very common measurement that people want if they want to build a delivering in a carpet.
Yes. It's going to be 113 inches between each bed.
And then can we do from here to the desk?
Yes. Keep in mind these are movable pieces, so you do have flexibility.
Right.
About 109 inches. So yeah, you can move them around however you like. It's up to you to get your room how you like it. I know those first couple days I moved my room around a lot.
Yeah.
Because you're always trying to find your zen place where you feel that the room is complete. So, we're going to take time to do that.
Well, we thank you for your questions that have come in, and we'll hang out for another second or two if anybody has anything.
Air conditioning. Mm-hmm. So, this is a building that switches over air. So, in the like hotter months, it's going to have the air conditioning cooling. And in the colder months, it's going to have it on warm. So you can't switch back and forth. You'll get an email ahead of time when they're switching it. So you'll know, but you also can't change it back. You can just go up and down the temperature. But if it's hot, it's going to blow hot. If it's cold, it's going to blow cold.
So when you live in a hall like that, and it's November, and we've turned it to heat, and it's, I don't know, 60, 70 degrees on a weird November day.
Yeah.
What steps would you recommend to students so that they can, you know, remain as comfortable as possible?
Open your windows, open your doors. If you're cold, grab an extra blanket. If you're hot, I guess, if you have any more summer clothes, you could walk around in that. But it's not that bad. Also, don't mess with the buttons because that could mess up the functionality of it and then you'll really be upset. It's really not working the way it should be. But yeah, opening windows usually really helps cool the room down.
Portable fans.
Yeah. No heaters.
Right.
You can't bring a heater. You can't bring a heated blanket.
Safety hazards.
So you can't bring that. But just regular blankets, pile on. It works. I promise. Because I hate being cold too. Just bring an extra blanket.
Perfect. Well.
Any other questions?
We don't have any right now, but remember you guys can always, view this after we post it and leave comments, and we will still go back and answer those for you guys.
And if you're living in another hall, we'll be doing some other tours throughout the next couple weeks. We're going to do Walton Hall today at 2 p.m., so if you're going to live in Walton, you can join us then if you just want to see the other buildings.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you can just kind of sign us off. If there's anything you want to, tell the upcoming freshmen.
Y'all are really lucky. The campus is great. You're going to love it. I mean, I loved all my time here. I can't believe that I'm going into my last year. So enjoy the time. Welcome to the University of Arkansas. And woo pig suey.
Yep. Thank you guys for tuning in.